Good setting here in Salamanca.
Yeah, absolutely. This is just a gorgeous complex, somewhere in the vicinity of about a $16 million complex here in Salamanca with football, baseball, softball, and soccer, and lacrosse. So feel like the big time here, Kyle. The rights to this broadcast have been granted by Section 6, representing more than 90 senior high schools who participate annually in Section 6-sponsored athletic competition. Any rebroadcast or republication of the programming without written consent of Section 6 is strictly prohibited. Always wanted to say that.
Well, you just did.
Just
Ryan.
Did.
You have made the big time.
Man, I'll tell you, I feel large and in charge
yes,
here.
Yes, you do.
All right, as the CSP team is the home team for today's contest, Section 6, the host team this year. So Gabe Roth toes the rubber out on the mound. Alex Ellsworth, the catcher. First pitch ball low outside.
Ellsworth was Section 5 Class D Player of the Year in their league, Brian. So he's catching today, leading off. Good player for Fillmore.
And a head over top of the second baseman, jumping Trent Berchanowski over there at second. And he's got a leadoff single out into right field to lead the game off here.
Yeah, Fillmore gets the leadoff runner on, so we'll see how aggressive they want to be. From a CSP standpoint, traditional lineup today.
And they get a quick throw over to first base. That was a close call over there at first as the catcher dives in, and now we got a timeout. As I'm not sure if he jammed his shoulder or got the wind knocked out of him, but anyway, on the head first dive back into first base, he's going to get a minute to kind of collect his thoughts over there.
Yeah, it looks, Brian, I think it caught, just as it caught us off guard, it caught him off guard, and he just barely made it back to the base.
That was a close play over there. Good throw over from Gabe, good tag applied by Bryce at first base, and we just about cleared the bases off there. Back to live action now, though, as Ellsworth takes his lead over at first base. And there's a called strike by home plate umpire for the Far West Regional, Chad Bongiovanni. Marv Cummings, another Section 6 representative down the first baseline. And the Section 5 representative, well, I'm sorry we don't have a name for, is currently around the second base as we have a runner on first base.
As I was mentioning, Brian, pretty traditional lineup for CSP. Blake Copta in center, ball inside there for Gabe. But Tate Catney's in left, Blake Copta in center, Ian Dunwald in right. You've got Bryce Hinsdale at first, Trent Berchanowski at second, Austin White at short, Curtis Olson at third.
And another line drive over the top of Trent at second base. Fillmore's going to have the first two hitters on base with two singles almost exactly in the same spot. Line drive shots right over the top of a jumping Trent Berchanowski at his second base position, but a couple of line drive first base singles. That's got two base runners now.
Yeah, this is unusual or uncharted for CSP a little bit. Gabe getting hit here in the first inning. And so first and second for Fillmore with no outs here.
And a bunt down the first baseline. Gabe fields the ball from his pitching position, tags out the runner. His job was accomplished as he moved the runners from first and second over to second and third, but Gabe also smartly just held onto that ball and tagged the base runner out at first base.
Yeah, and a nice job by the third hitter there, Nolan
Krasminski.
He did his job, which was to lay down the bunt and advance the runners. So Fillmore's got something going here in the top of the first. We got runners at second and third for Fillmore with one out with Brent Zubikowski
with the cleanup hitter today for Fillmore, and he's got a swing and a miss, strike one. 1-1 now as we missed the ball the first pitch. 1-1 now to the cleanup hitter. Once again, one down here, top of the first inning, runners on second and third, and now a 2-1 count to Zubikowski, the cleanup hitter.
Good block there by Micah. That ball was in the dirt, so good job by Micah. This backstop, for those that are listening, the backstop is not that far back, so it will be difficult on a pass ball if you're a runner at third to try to steal home on a pass ball.
3-1 now to the cleanup hitter. And called strike down the middle. That's going to bring the count to full with one down here to the cleanup hitter, Brent Zubikowski. Zubikowski, a junior out of Fillmore. And swing and a miss, strike three, as the fastball got by him before he was able to catch up with it. So that's going to be Gabe Ross' first strikeout of the game, second out of the inning. And now we got two down, Kyle, and that's going to bring up the number five hitter, Aiden Wagner, playing third base today for Fillmore.
Yeah, that was a big strikeout for Gabe there, because now we got two outs. Now it's a ground ball. If you're in the infield, you knock it down and throw it to first. So totally different environment here with two outs.
Curveball called strike two by home plate umpire Chad Bongiovanni. 0-2 now to the third baseman, Aiden Wagner, Jr. out of Fillmore.
And we're set up, Brian, right behind home plate. It is first.
And that one's fouled down the right field line out into out of play territory down there.
So we have a good look at the pitches coming in. That was a really nice curveball two pitches ago by Gabe. But Fillmore up there getting bad on the ball, Brian, and making another Gabe work.
Curveball followed back to the screen here. Stays in play, but foul ball nonetheless. Still remains 0-2 to Wagner. And as you mentioned, a lot of contact. That's something that we have not seen a lot of when Gabe's been on the mound for the Wolfpack this year. And that one, swing and a miss, strike three. That's going to retire the side for the Wolfpack, courtesy of two Gabe Roths strikeouts and then one put out. But that means no runs, two hits, two left on base, no errors, and that's going to do it for the top half of the first inning. And we will be right back from Salamanca.
Podcast on the Channel 98.9 Lictus Oil and Propane Sports Stream is provided in part by J. Edwards Insurance. With offices at 9 East Main Street in Panama and 800 West 3rd Street in Jamestown, J. Edwards Insurance is an independent insurance service providing auto, business, farm, and homeowners insurance. We treat you like family. Online at jedwardsinsurance.com. Best of luck to the Wolfpack this season from J. Edwards Insurance, serving New York and Pennsylvania since 1957. Funding for this Channel 98.9 Sports Stream broadcast comes from Lictus Oil and Propane in Clymer. Family-owned Lictus Oil and Propane continues to supply liquids and fluids for agriculture, industry, and homeowners. Heating oil and propane services and off and on diesel fuel services are also offered. The Channel 98.9 Sports Stream thanks Lictus Oil and Propane for their continued support.
In baseball, these are the moments that bring us to our feet.
But the most important moment happens when we all stand together.
United for a great cause.
So join Major League Baseball and stand up to cancer.
As we stand in honor of all loved ones affected by this disease.
I'm Jordana Brewster.
I'm Candace Patton.
Joe Manganiello.
I'm Matt Damon. Cancer has in some way touched all of us.
Visit standuptocancer.org/MLB.
Stand up with us.
Support for Wolfpack baseball coverage is provided by Sherman Country General Store at 177 West Main Street in Sherman. Gasoline, groceries, and more. Phone 716-761-6181. Go Wolfpack from Sherman Country General Store.
Welcome back to Salamanca Memorial Park here in Salamanca, New York, where we are in the middle portion of the first inning with CSP 0. Fillmore 0. Fillmore got some base runners in the first, top of the first, had a couple hits, got to second and third base, and then Gabe Roth proceeded to strike the last two batters out in what could have been a little bit of a sticky situation for CSP. So got out of the top of the first, maybe relieved a little bit of nerves for CSP, and Austin White comes to the plate.
As Austin takes first pitch, looking, strike one down the middle. Pitcher for today is Damon Potter. He is a ninth grader, actually, out of Fillmore here. Ball on the inside corner. So it continues with some of the younger pitchers that we've seen throughout the course of the year this year. Fillmore not afraid to throw the freshman out in a pretty big spot here, Far West Regional. Well, here's the
And a little bit of information, there's a strike, swinging strike for Austin, so it's 1-2 now. But the little bit of information we were able to conjure up, Brian, on Fillmore, they do have a four or five pitchers that they have no issue starting. And
fastball outside and low.
Tuesday night, Graham Cahill went the distance for Fillmore in their sectional final game. You know, you read a little bit about Zach Sisson, who is a lefty for Fillmore, who's been pretty good. But today we're seeing Damon Potter. So, and he goes full count here on Austin White.
Austin doing a nice job up there, taking some pitches. Been a couple outside, one inside. Got the count to full here. Once again, no score. And Austin fouled one off the inside corner of his ankle. That's going to be a little painful for him. He's going to take a walk behind the base here and try and get the feeling back in his ankle, I'm assuming. So once again, full count here. Bottom of the first inning. No score here from Salamanca as Austin White kind of trying to shake that ankle loose after taking one off the inside part of the, I'm assuming the ankle bone is what it kind of looked like. Now he's back into his spot. Full count here. And Austin hits one hard toward the second baseman. He's quickly over there, throws over to first base, and that's going to retire the first batter of the inning. Be a 4-3 put out. Pretty sure-handed play over there by the second baseman.
Yeah, good piece of hitting there by
good at bat there by Austin.
Austin. Yep. Took him deep in the count and at least made contact. So Bryce Hinsdale now up to bat for CSP.
Curveball high and outside. And that one low and inside.
It'd be important, Brian, particularly with a ninth grader in Potter on the mound, to get base runners early and see if we can get some runs on the.
And there's a high chopper down toward first. The first baseman fields that while it's still in fair territory, and then makes a kind of a difficult play look relatively easy over there. And that's going to be the second batter retired as Bryce is going to be put out by the first baseman. Big high bounce here off the turf in Salamanca and just stayed down the inside of the foul line over there. The first baseman grabbed it. Actually, his momentum took him out into foul territory, but he promptly stepped back on the base. Two outs now, and that one makes its way back to the backstop. Ball one for Gabe Roth.
If you're CSP, Brian, what you're trying to do, you're trying to hit line drives, particularly on this fast turf. And so far you've had the first two batters have kind of hit not necessarily slow.
And Gabe pops one up way high over here out of play behind the Fillmore dugout. It ends up on top of the bullpen screen over there. So that's going to be a ball we're probably not going to see again today unless you got somebody with long, long arms. And there's a called strike on the inside corner. One ball, two strikes now to Gabe.
Potter said to Gabe, I'll see your curveball and raise you one.
And Gabe hits a line drive down the left field line. That's going to be called fair. Down the left field line, Gabe makes a big turnaround first base, but he probably made a smart decision to stay at first base there as that left fielder got to that ball pretty quickly and got the relay down to the cutoff man. So Gabe Roth is aboard with a single. First base runner of the day for the Wolfpack. And that's going to bring up Micah Willink for the Wolfpack in the number four position here with two outs, runner on first. No score here in bottom of the first inning.
That ball was hard hit, Brian, by Gabe right down third base line.
Throw over to first base, not quite far away. Similarly to the backstop behind home plate, the fencing is fairly close here down both lines. Even though this is a brand-new ballpark, they did kind of squeeze it in the old footprint of the old one, so it's a little tight with real estate here. Micah, foul ball off the front part of the plate, and quickly one ball, one strike to Micah. No balls, one strike.
We'll see how aggressive Coach Moreno wants to be. And there goes Gabe right there.
And that one gets away from the catcher, so Gabe's going to be into second on a stand-up. stolen base. So now we got a runner in scoring position via the stolen base for Gabe Roth. One ball, one strike. Now to Micah.
Yeah, base hit here more than likely, Brian, depending on where it's at. Base hit here probably does score Gabe.
And that one's right into the gap between left and center field, and that one's going to make its way all the way to the fence. Micah Willink motoring around first base into second with a stand-up double. RBI scoring Gabe Roth from second base. Big hit for the senior out of Clymer.
Yeah, great job by Micah. That ball was outside, Brian. He took it to left center right between the left fielder, and there's a lot of room out there.
Man, this is
left fielder and center field, and Gabe was Gabe easily scored from second. Now we again have Trent Burchanowski at the plate with a runner in scoring position with CSP up 1-0 here.
It's 320 down the left field line, 315 down the right, and I don't see a sign out in center field, but I guess if tradition holds, it's probably in the 360 category out there somewhere.
Yeah, it looks like a long ways, Brian.
That's a balk.
And that is a balk.
So that's going to bring Micah on the balk call from home plate umpire Chad Bomgiovanni. Is going to make his way over to third base on the walk. I think he started his motion and stopped is what actually happened there. So that's going to move Micah from second over to third. And a swing and a miss by Trent. Strike one for him.
All this, Brian, being done with CSP having two outs. First two batters grounding out. So a little two-out lightning here. Gets a run on the board with potentially some more here.
And that one way low and outside. The all-star catcher from Fillmore did a nice job to keep that one from going to the backstop. Once again, we're not overly familiar with Fillmore. We know it's a little bit north of Houghton. It's just on the southern part of the Letchworth State Park. But as far as schools and athletic teams, we know they're the Eagles. We know they're 19-3. Other than that, we don't know an awful lot about Fillmore.
Yeah, we spent the week, Brian, trying to find articles, trying to find...
That one does make its way to the backstop. Micah's trying to get in from his first. They got him on the close play at the plate. Micah had a good jump, but that short backstop here at Salamanca allowed the catcher to catch up to the ball, and the pitcher promptly tied the tag. And close play at the plate. Pitcher did a nice job hanging on to that and tag out Micah at home.
Yeah, we talked about that in the pregame, Brian, that this the backstop here is not that far behind home plate. So I think CSP needs to evaluate whether that is how we want to approach pass balls, because I think there's a real question that if there's a pass ball and we have a runner at third, that may not be an automatic. The only thing I can think of, Brian, is that as that ball comes back and is the ball's going to have a little bit, because of the backstop is a little bit closer to home plate, that ball's going to have a little bit more speed when it hits the fence. The question is, does it hit that fence harder than normal and bounce to the left or right? That ball did not in the case of for Fillmore. That ball bounced right back to their all-star catcher. He turned, and it was a very close plate.
Sure was.
And play at the plate. But that marked the third out of the inning, but not before CSP got a run on the board. So it's 1-0 CSP here after one, and we'll see if Gabe Roth settles in here. The history with Gabe has been he gets stronger as the game goes on, and again got out of a little bit of a nail biter situation in the top of the first, was able to score a run in the bottom of the first. I'd like to think that might help some of the nerves that CSP may have had as they came into this game. So hopefully we can get settled in and play good baseball here going forward.
Yeah, so as we start the second inning here, it's going to be the number 6, 7, 8 batters coming to the plate for Fillmore here. And like we said, they did have a lot of action on the base paths. CSP did well to get out of that first inning without giving up any runs. And flip side, CSP also produced some activity in their half of the first inning, and we did get one run across. So the score is now 1-0 CSP over Fillmore, top of the second inning. This is going to bring Luke Colombo playing left field to bat, the junior out of Fillmore. High and outside, ball one to Luke Colombo. called strike. Right on the corner of the plate, Kyle. Good pitch.
Yep. Yeah, right on the corner in the right at the knees. That ball was very good spot because it would have been a very difficult ball to hit. And if it was hit, it was going to be a grounder to the right side of the field for sure.
That ball, good left and right, but at a little bit lower than the knees. So ball two now to Colombo, 2-1. 3-1 as that one goes down in the dirt. Gabe laboring just a little on the mound here, even though he had two strikeouts in the first inning. Just a little bit, maybe some nerves going on here for the junior. And called strike on the outside corner.
Well,
good pitch.
We haven't had a game all week, Brian. Last time CSP played was last Sunday, and Fillmore played Tuesday night. So, you know, it's, some of that is getting more comfortable on a different mound and he hasn't been on a mound in roughly a week. But there's a walk there to Luke Colombo, the number six hitter for Fillmore. So that brings to plate Graham Cahill playing right field today and batting seventh.
And again, a throw over to first base, and promptly back is Colombo. Bryce Hinsdale applied the tag, but nothing doing over there at first base. As the we got a lot of activity up here in the press box. We got NFHS doing game. We got the PA announcer. You got us. And the mic was left on for the field here. So somebody's broadcast was making it out over the speakers. So we got that fixed here right quickly. One ball, no strikes to Graham Cahill.
Important here, Brian, for Gabe to find the strike zone a little bit. It's unusual to see him labor on the mound. And couple hits by Fillmore in the first inning. Now leadoff walk here in the second, and down 2-0 to the second batter. So you want him to find his zone here.
And that one gets away from Micah back to the fence on an inside pitch by Gabe that's going to allow the runner to advance to second. So CSP defense just a smidge out of sorts here as Gabe falls behind 3-0 to Cahill. Runner on second base now, running scoring position. No outs here, top of the second inning. 1-0 CSP over Fillmore is your score. And called strike, 3-1 now to Cahill.
Yeah, and I got to think you knew Fillmore was Cahill's taking all the way there. I wouldn't be surprised, Brian, if he takes another one here just because of Gabe's little struggles.
Called strike two now. So they're back on good territory here. Full count now to Cahill as Gabe comes back with quickly two called strikes. Ball four as Micah makes his way over to block that one. And that's two walks to lead off the second inning here. And so Gabe struggling a little bit out there on the mound.
Yeah, a little unusual. We have not seen this from Gabe. And, you know, and particularly, you know, it's the trouble with the walks here is that you're 6-7, batter 6-7. So you're, you know.
And there's one. Bunted back over to Gabe, and he promptly makes the play from his pitching position. He actually ended up on the ground on the delivery of that one. But job accomplished for Jude Beardsley as he sacrifices the runners from first and second, now second and third with one out. So one down now. Same situation we had in the top of the first. Runners on second and third. This is going to bring Damon Potter, today's pitcher, looking to help himself out here a little bit as Gabe gets a called strike. Potter, the freshman, batting in the number nine position today for Fillmore.
Gotta love it, Brian. No gloves, no batting gloves.
Nope.
Which is very unusual to see nowadays, which going a little old school, which you like.
Yep. 1-1 now to Potter. And that one sails a little high and inside. Gabe struggling just a little bit. That ball is sailing a little high on him, which would indicate maybe he's not getting the full stretch out. That one's outside. 3-1 now. Gabe really struggling out there from what we've traditionally been used to seeing out of him this year. That one foul tip back into Micah's face mask. So he's going to take just a second. collect his thoughts.
Yeah, that went off his face mask, off the shoulder pad, catcher's gear. So
looks like he's good
to
go.
He's going to be fine.
Yep. Home plate umpire Bongiovanni checks in. Everything seems to be a go. So now full count now. One down here. Top of the second inning. Runners on second and third. And a foul ball that's going to be out of play down here behind the Fillmore dugout. Staying alive out there is Potter.
And if you're Fillmore, you're looking at this, and not only is Gabe struggling a little bit, Brian, finding the strike zone, but they're going deep into counts on most of these batters, which, you know, as you think about pitch count and making sure that
And he got him on the look and called third strike. So that's going to be a big out number two here in the second inning. Called third strike. That was right on the corner. Good call by the umpire. But curveball high for the leadoff batter. Now Alex Ellsworth coming to the plate with two on, two down here in the bottom or top of the second inning.
Ellsworth singled to right field in the first inning, Brian. Hit a hard hit to right field and kind of got their inning started. So
Gabe got by him on the fastball. 1-1 now.
Big bat here for Phil Fillmore.
Curveball on the outside. Misses. Two balls and a strike now to the leadoff batter. Yeah, like you said, Ellsworth had a hard line drive over the top of Trent Burchanowski at second base in that first inning to lead the game off. And Gabe, another one, high heat, couldn't catch up with it. 2-2 now to Ellsworth.
Yeah, Brian, and I would not hesitate to go right back there and let him try to chase that high fastball and catch it. And
foul tip back. Wow, that was back in a hurry.
Yeah, well, that came right at us.
For sure did.
I almost buckled a little bit.
I might have. We got a fence in the window in front of us, and I still flinched. 2-2 now to Ellsworth. Two down. Back-to-back strikeouts. Here's the 2-2. And he does. Swing and a miss, strike three. Couldn't catch up with that high heater, Kyle. Like you said, that's a good spot, good way to come back after a little bit of a rough start to that inning. Once again, Fillmore leaving two runners on base. And Gabe gets himself out of a potential pinch. And that's going to remain score CSP 1, Fillmore 0, as we get ready to enter the bottom half of the second. We'll be right back.
98.9 Sports Stream broadcast comes from Lictus Oil and Propane in Clymer. Family-owned Lictus Oil and Propane continues to supply liquids and fluids for agriculture, industry, and homeowners. Heating oil and propane services and off-and-on diesel fuel services are also offered. The Channel 98.9 Sports Stream thanks Lictus Oil and Propane for their continued support.
This Wolfpack broadcast is brought to you in part by Arlene's Dutch Kitchen Restaurant and Becky's Bakery at 104 East Main Street in Sherman. Arlene's offers breakfast, lunch, and dinner. Becky's Bakery features Amish-style baked goods. 716-234-4002 or Arlene's Dutch Kitchen on Facebook.
If you could do something today that could save someone's life, would you do it? If it didn't cost you a dime and only took a little time and could literally save a life, would you do it? Can you believe that only 3% of people say yes to this? How's that possible? That's the real percentage of people who give blood. It's something you can do whether you're a millionaire, middle class, or completely poor. There's no fee and it's easy to do. And you can literally save a life. Let's roll up our sleeves and make a difference. Give blood. We can do better than 3%. Learn more at redcrossblood.org.
Funding for coverage of CSP Baseball on the Channel 98.9 Lictus Oil and Propane Sports Stream is provided in part by First Place Auto Glass of Jamestown. Owner Glass Tech Robert Leonard from Panama installs automotive glass and works with all major insurance companies. We thank First Place Auto Glass, 716-450-0847, or on Facebook.
Hey, welcome back to Salamanca as we get ready to start the bottom half of the second inning. Trent Burchanowski is going to lead off the second inning again as we ended the first with the really close play on the sliding Micah Willink into second base on the pass ball. Called out, but that's going to bring Trent back up with a fresh count here to start the second inning for the Wolfpack. 1-0 lead for the Wolfpack. Bottom of the second. And that one sails over top of Trent's head.
Yeah, that ball ended up on the other side of Trent's head.
Yeah.
So good way to get out of the way and, more importantly, dropped his bat, which eliminate.
And that one, another one high and inside there. 2-0 now quickly to Trent. Both pitchers struggling a little bit with this mound. It's all artificial out here, folks. There's not an ounce of dirt anywhere. And Trent hits a deep line drive that's going to be got the left fielder on his horse. And that one's going to be a home run for Trent Berchanowski. Leadoff home run over the left field power alley. Trent Berchanowski with a moonshot over top of the head of the left fielder. I thought that he got a lot of that, Kyle. I wasn't sure he got all he needed, but he sure did. That ends up out on the football field here in Salamanca. Big leadoff home run for Trent Berchanowski.
Yeah, he got all of that, Brian. He really, you know, anytime Trent swings, it's 150 miles an hour, and he made all the contact he needed there, and that ball was deep, I'm telling you.
And Curtis Olson up now as the CSP team celebrates Trent in the dugout. Curtis Olson out on the field now. Takes the first one, ball high and outside. 1-0 to Curtis. And curveball on the inside corner now. 2-0 to Curtis. As that probably, you would think, might have shook the freshman pitcher just a little bit from Fillmore.
Yeah, I'd be curious if I'm Fillmore's coach.
Curtis gets the bat on the ball. It's a hard-charging shortstop for Fillmore. Throw in the dirt. Curtis is going to reach, but he's going to stay on the pass ball past the first baseman. Like we mentioned, the real estate here is a little tight, so it didn't allow Curtis to make the turn over towards second base. But he's going to reach via an error on the throw from the shortstop, on the charging shortstop. Couldn't get the ball over in a good position for the first baseman to make a play on that.
Yeah, and again, Brian, leadoff home run. You want to see how, if you're Fillmore and their coaching staff, you want to see how your team responds. Your shortstop now just makes a poor throw to first. CSP gets now a runner on first base. If you're Fillmore, you want to just get settled in, play good defense, and help your freshman pitcher on the mound.
Freshman pitcher to freshman hitter, Tate Catney's now taking a pitch high and inside. 1-1 now to Tate as he took the first pitch that was a called strike. 1-1 now to Tate Catney's with Curtis Olson on first base. Tate kind of squared around like he was going to try and sacrifice bunt it and pulled the bat back. And that one he does actually bunt, and that goes back to the pitcher quickly over to first base. So that's going to retire Tate, but he's got a job well accomplished as he moved Curtis from his first base position over to second. And a sacrifice bunt by Tate, job accomplished there for the freshman.
Yep, did what he was asked to do, and that puts a runner in scoring position with Curtis at second base, and that brings Grant Lictus to the plate just the second game of the season after coming off the injured list.
Big lefty as the pitcher turns around to throw, but neither the shortstop nor the second baseman were near the bag. Curtis dove back, but there was no play there as both of them were set to be in their defensive position. So he toes the rubber again now from the stretch position. And high and outside to Grant. One ball, no strikes. And called strike right down Main Street on that one for Grant. 1-1 now.
Yeah, Grant, for those that do not know, Grant suffered a foot injury and has been out all year long and came back at the sectional final game last week. And every time he got up, Brian, it was a key at bat, and he did a great job of either getting a bat on the ball or getting a walk. So and again, today he comes up in a big spot.
And a swing and a miss for the freshman out of Clymer, and that's going to be the first out of their second out of the inning now. First via strikeout as Grant goes down swinging. But two outs now, but Curtis Olson remains at second base for Ian Dunnewald, the senior. We'll see what Ian's got in store for us. High and inside. Ball one to Ian. Once again, 2-0 your score. CSP over Fillmore. Bottom half of the second inning. Two down here. Curtis Olson on second. Ian Dunnewald at the bat. As Potter steps off the rubber.
And we've had good production out of Ian all spring here, Brian. And so this is not an unusual spot for him. And he's come up big in a lot of these positions with big hits at big times. And this would be one of those times where a base hit here, anything to the outfield, to more than likely score in Curtis at second.
1-1 high and outside goes that one. 2-1 now to Ian Dunnewald. Good pitcher, or good hitters count here. And it's going to be called strike on the inside corner. 2-2 now to Ian.
Again, umpiring today, very consistent. Both pitchers getting that outside.
And Ian did a good job defending that one off down the right field line. Foul ball against the catch fence over here in Salamanca. And he just fought that one off and kind of went with it. That was going to be close.
It was going to be close. That was a great piece of hitting, to
yes,
be honest
it was.
With you, Brian, because that ball was going to be close. Yeah, he was a little late on it. He just stuck his bat out there. And
there's a high chopper toward the pitcher. He's going to take it himself over to first base and step on the base, not going to risk the exchange on the throw. So he promptly runs over to first base and retires Ian Dunnewald. But not before the CSP team, via Trent Burchanowski home run, leadoff home run in the inning, makes the score now 2-0, CSP over Fillmore. We'll be right back.
98.9 Sports Stream broadcast comes from Lictus Oil and Propane in Clymer. Family-owned, Lictus Oil and Propane continues to supply liquids and fluids for agriculture, industry, and homeowners. Heating oil and propane services and off-and-on diesel fuel services are also offered. The Channel 98.9 Sports Stream thanks Lictus Oil and Propane for their continued support.
I can't see that. I can't even see
support
that.
For coverage of CSP baseball on the Channel 98.9 Lictus Oil and Propane Sports Stream is provided by Triple E Manufacturing in Sherman. Triple E offers equine products, promotional items, embroidery, and printing services. 800-295-4282 or online at tripleemanufacturing.com.
Funding for this broadcast on the Channel 98.9 Lictus Oil and Propane Sports Stream is provided in part by J. Edwards Insurance. With offices at 9 East Main Street in Panama and 800 West 3rd Street in Jamestown, J. Edwards Insurance is an independent insurance service providing auto, business, farm, and homeowners insurance. We treat you like family. Online at jedwardsinsurance.com. Best of luck to the Wolfpack this season from J. Edwards Insurance, serving New York and Pennsylvania since 1957. This broadcast of CSP Wolfpack Baseball is provided by Land Pro Equipment at 1756 Lindquist Drive in Falconer and 8926 West Main Street in Clymer. Online at landproequip.com.
As we return to live action here in Salamanca, top of the third inning now. First pitch fouled away by the number two hitter for the Fillmore Eagles, Zach Sisson, who had a hard line drive shot over Trent Burchanowski in the first inning. And a partial swing and a miss there. 0-2 now quickly up on Sisson.
You mentioned, Brian, Trent Burchanowski with a home run in to right center. Or left center in
fouled off behind the home plate fence here.
In the bottom of the second, just getting a text that the Salamanca resident who attends many of the games said that's the first time he's seen a home run here at the new Memorial
Park.
Well,
how about that?
So that may not be accurate, but that's the first one he's seen, so that's pretty impressive.
Yep, that's fantastic news and a big hit for the junior. Man, that's awesome. 0-2 now, Sisson. And he got him on the high outside pitch. Good pitch there by Gabe Roth. Retires the first batter of the inning via strikeout. Gabe, even though he's laboring, that's his fifth strikeout of the day here, Kyle.
Yeah, he put that ball out of the strike zone. The big lefty for Fillmore chased it and able to get a strikeout. And
that one's a pop fly out to Ian Dunnewald in right field. Clamped underneath it. No problem at all for the right fielder, as that's going to quickly be on one pitch. Fly out to the right fielder, and Ian Dunnewald records the second out of the inning for the Wolfpack.
And after two relatively difficult innings, the first two innings, Brian, this is a much needed efficient inning here for Gabe. So he's got two outs with about three pitches thrown, and that brings Brent Zubikowski to the plate, who
And another pop fly up down the right field line. Bryce Hinsdale camped underneath it. And that's a very efficient third inning for Gabe Roth, as that, I believe, is a five-out or five-pitch inning. And fly out to Bryce Hinsdale at the first base position. And the 2-3-4 batters for Fillmore go down 1-2-3. And that's going to put a quick end to the third inning for the Fillmore Eagles.
Yeah, much needed inning for Gabe. To your point, we had commented earlier, he labored through the first two innings, where Fillmore saw the four base runners, two in each inning, and they left him stranded and come back in the third with five pitches or so. That's huge for Gabe and CSP. So with that, we're going to pay some bills, and we'll be right back in 2 minutes.
On the Channel 98.9 Lictus Oil and Propane Sports Stream is provided in part by J. Edwards Insurance. With offices at 9 East Main Street in Panama and 800 West 3rd Street in Jamestown, J. Edwards Insurance is an independent insurance service providing auto, business, farm, and homeowners insurance. We treat you like family. Online at jedwardsinsurance.com. Best of luck to the Wolfpack this season from J. Edwards Insurance, serving New York and Pennsylvania since 1957. This broadcast of CSP Wolfpack Baseball is brought to you by Pudge's Tire at 5979 Niobe Road in Panama, serving all your tire needs. Phone 716-782-4009.
Coverage of CSP Wolfpack Baseball is provided in part by White Land Surveying in Clymer, providing land surveys for clients in Chautauqua and Cattaraugus counties in New York and Erie, Warren, and Crawford counties in Pennsylvania. Call 716-499-8410 or visit.
All right, as we return to a live action here in Salamanca, bottom of the third inning, CSP holding on to a 2-0 lead as the top of the order now. Austin White's going to make his way out to the plate. And one down the foul, down the first baseline here for Austin. Is he out ahead of that one just a little bit?
Austin 0-1 on the day. He grounded out to the second baseman, kind of a lazy ground out in the first inning. So looking to get on the score sheet here in the top of the third. Bottom of the third, excuse me.
High and outside now, 1-1 to Austin. Once again here, just an absolutely gorgeous facility and a gorgeous day. Man, temperature in the high 60s, that's perfect. That one way outside, 2-1 now to Austin.
And again, freshman pitcher for Fillmore on the mound today, Damon Potter, and he's labored through the first two innings. We'll see if he can settle himself down here in the third. A difficult ask considering the top of the order for CSP, but he handled them pretty well back in the first inning.
Yeah, real good in that first inning. And Austin fouls that one back behind us here in the press box at Salamanca, and that's going to bring the count to full.
That's a pitch that Austin would want back, Brian. That ball was right down the middle of the plate. That was a hitter's pitch, and he just missed it. Got good bat on it. Just foul ball back over the backstop.
Potter steps back off the mound. Had to wipe some sweat off his head, I think. So Austin steps out accordingly, and we're ready to go here now. And that one's going to be way outside again. Austin White's going to earn a base on balls as the leadoff hitter in the bottom half of the third inning here. That's going to bring Bryce Hinsdale up, and that's going to get a visit from the coaching staff at Fillmore. So we'll see what's in store here, if he's just going to try and settle him down or is he going to get the quick hook. He actually has been pitching real good, Kyle. I don't have a problem with the way he's been pitching. It's his first walk issued today right there. That was it.
Yeah, this is just—it's such a difficult lineup to face. You know, even if you're particularly a young kid, it's just there's no relief in the lineup, Brian. From 1 to 9, they can all hit the ball, and they can all hit the ball hard. And so we are going to get
a pitching change. They're going to swap positions. It looks like the shortstop's going to come in, and
no, this is the left fielder, Brian. This is Luke Colombo.
Okay,
is going to come in for relief.
He had slid into the standing on the shortstop position. That's what I thought. Yeah. So yeah, he came in from his. He knew he was coming. A little different dimensions for the big lefty or the big right-handed left fielder. He's about 6 inches taller than Potter, I'm going to think.
Yeah, they just swapped positions. So yep. Potter went to left, and Colombo comes in from his left field position. So we'll see. He's one of the five pitchers that, Brian, and at least the minimal information we were able to get on Fillmore, they've got about five pitchers that they have no issue going to, and Colombo is one of those. We've seen now two pitchers for Fillmore. We know Cahill went seven innings on Tuesday night for Fillmore. We know Zach Sisson, big, tall, lanky sophomore lefty for Fillmore is can also pitch. So at this point in time, well, we may see all of them. Anytime your season's on the line, yep. There's no reason to hold back. And as soon as you start to see some a pitcher struggle and you know, you're going to want to make that move. And we may even see that from the CSP angle.
Yeah. Yep.
You know, CSP's got four or five pitchers that they feel very, very comfortable going to. So
Bryce Hinsdale makes his way out. Runner on first base, no outs here, bottom of the third. Called strike right down Broadway on that one. Bryce Hinsdale got a look at it now. It's the first time he's seen a pitch from this pitcher.
Look to look for something here to drive if I'm Bryce and make good contact.
And he hits one, kind of a high choppy one over towards second. They get the force at second base, but the throw over pulled the second baseman off of the bag. So Bryce is going to be aboard via fielder's choice. And he does get the base at first, but the lead runner. And now we got a little meeting at the second base to see if they did pull the foot or not, as Jake Marino from CSP is out talking to both field umpires. And both field umpires agree that the toe did get down before Austin was able to get over there. So that's going to wipe the Austin off the base paths, but it's still going to leave Bryce over at first with Gabe coming up to bat with one down now.
Yeah, that's not what you necessarily wanted if you're Bryce. But he's on base, and now we'll see how aggressive Coach Marino wants to be with the base runners. And Gabe Roth at the plate, who looked at ball one, the first pitch.
Bryce taking a three-step lead over at first base. There's a high ball two to Gabe Roth, 2-0 now.
As we commented earlier, Brian, all-star catcher behind the plate, so I don't necessarily know this is a position if you're Coach Marino that you want to be running in, but we'll see. See what he wants to do.
A little bigger lead now for Bryce over at first. Big timeout called by Gabe as the pitcher was in a long delay. I think he was trying to figure out if he wanted to try and throw over to first base, as Bryce had take that three-step lead now to 3.5. And a foul down the left field line, out of play.
As we look down the third base line, Brian, a fantastic crowd here for both teams, but CSP has a really nice
grandstands are filled.
The grandstands are filled. They're full all the way down from third base down to the foul pole on the left field side. So really, really nice crowd for CSP today.
Foul ball right around the catcher position back here as the ball hit in foul territory. Catcher promptly underneath it, but foul ball called. So that's going to be a count now, 2-2 to Gabe, one down here, bottom of the third. Bryce Hinsdale at first base, out with a pretty healthy lead in there. He keeps kind of inching out a little further every time. And Gabe with a high, towering pop fly up towards second base. Second baseman over, and he's going to make the out. So a little less than what Gabe was hoping for to help his own cause out there as he pops out to the second baseman.
The catcher, number 14, Micah Willink.
And this is going to bring Micah back up. Two down now. Bottom of the third, one on. Bryce Hinsdale is on first base. Micah hit the two-out gapper in the first inning to bring this first CSP run across the plate.
2-0 CSP here in the bottom of third, and You know, this is a big spot for Micah. If he can find a gap, that may be able to score a fairly speedy Bryce Hinsdale from first.
Micah takes first ball. A little low and inside, 1-0 to Micah. And that one outside and high, 2-0 now to Micah. And I don't know. Two outs. Do you don't give him a lot to hit? Maybe. I don't know.
Yeah, the trouble if you're in there, there's another ball high and outside. And,
problem is the next guy up hit a home run.
Yeah, Trent Burchanowski on deck for CSP, who and back in the second inning. Hit one about 375 feet or so for a home run.
Called strike. 3-1 as Micah was taken all the way on that one. 3-1 now, two down here. Bottom of the third inning, 2-0 CSP lead over Fillmore. Bryce Hinsdale at first base. Micah Willink at the plate. 3-1 to Micah, and he fouls one down the left field line.
That ball a little outside and low, Brian, but close enough for Micah to at least want to try to put bat on the ball, and he did a nice job of fouling that ball off.
So that brings the count to full. And ball inside he takes. So that's going to put Micah down at first base, going to move Bryce over to second. And that's going to bring Trent Burchanowski up, the hero of the second inning. A little different situation now as we got two on, two down here, bottom of the third. Big spot for the hard-hitting second baseman from Clymer.
And with two outs, Brian, any contact bat on the ball, those runners.
And there's a line drive down the left field line. It's going to be fair. Bryce Hinsdale's on his horse around third. He's going to score easily as he trips over home plate and lands on his butt. But that's going to make sure he better step on the plate, but I'm pretty sure he touched that thing.
Yeah, he actually put his foot on the home plate, and it was slippery.
Yep, I think, and, yep. So anyway, he hops up, no foul.
He got that little move from his mother.
Yeah, that looked just like something that Bryn would do right there.
Absolutely.
Exactly. But anyway, big RBI single for Trent Burchanowski, and scores Bryce from his second base position. Micah promptly stops at second base, so we still have runners at first and second, still two down, as that's going to bring up Curtis Olson.
And again, Brian, here in the third inning, CSP doing all of this with two outs. Did this back in the second inning, got a run with a little two out lightning, and again here in the third to get that third run on the board. 3-0 CSP here with two outs in the bottom of the third.
And there's a ball outside. Curtis wisely hangs off that one. One ball and two strikes now. Curtis been swinging a really hot bat here, especially the second half of the season for the Wolfpack. And they got him looking. But Burchanowski is once again going to get the RBI single that scores Bryce Hinsdale from second base, so that's going to push the third run of the day across. And CSP is enjoying a 3-0 lead over Fillmore as we enter the top half of the fourth inning. We'll be right back.
Podcast on the Channel 98.9 Lictus Oil and Propane Sports Stream is provided in part by J. Edwards Insurance. With offices at 9 East Main Street in Panama and 800 West 3rd Street in Jamestown, J. Edwards Insurance is an independent insurance service providing auto, business, farm, and homeowners insurance. We treat you like family. Online at jedwardsinsurance.com. Best of luck to the Wolfpack this season from J. Edwards Insurance, serving New York and Pennsylvania since 1957. This broadcast of CSP Wolfpack Baseball is brought to you by Pudge's Tire at 5979 Niobe Road in Panama, serving all your tire needs. Phone 716-782-4009.
Coverage of CSP Wolfpack Baseball is provided in part by White Land Surveying and Clymer, providing land surveys for clients in Chautauqua and Cattaraugus counties in New York and Erie, Warren, and Crawford counties in Pennsylvania. Call 716-499-8410 or visit online at mwhitepls.com.
Funding for this Channel 98.9 Sports Stream broadcast comes from Lictus Oil and Propane in Clymer. Family-owned Lictus Oil and Propane continues to supply liquids and fluids for agriculture, industry, and homeowners. Heating oil and propane services and off-and-on diesel fuel services are also offered. The Channel 98.9 Sports Stream thanks Lictus Oil and Propane for their continued support.
And welcome back to Salamanca as the CSP team currently enjoys a 3-0 lead over Fillmore. Top of the fourth inning here, and status quo as far as pitching is concerned for the Wolfpack. Gabe Roth's going to return back to the rubber, and he's going to face the number six hitter for Fillmore, Aiden Wagner. Called strike.
Wagner struck out, Brian, in the first inning, and got out of that was the third out of a bit of a jam for Gabe. So and again, this is coming off a very efficient top of the third.
Yeah, I don't know if Gabe. You do it any better than that. Five pitches is what I had. And foul tip caught by Micah. It's going to be strike two. One ball, two strikes now to Aiden Wagner. And this is kind of a story we've seen throughout the year here, and you hate to get ahead of yourself, but Gabe traditionally has gotten stronger as the game has gone on here. And that one, a swing and a miss off of Micah's helmet. Actually, a swing and a foul tip off of Micah's helmet.
That hit him pretty good,
it
Brian.
It did, too. Last couple games have been a little rough on the catcher and the umpiring staff as well. They've all taken their share. Curveball. Hit out toward Gabe at the pitcher's mound. He promptly in and throws over to first base. So he retires Wagner on a hit back to the pitcher. 1-3 ground ball there. And pretty efficient at bat there. That's going to bring up Luke Colombo.
Yeah, good job by Gabe playing his position. And that gets an easy out to start here the top of the fourth.
So the pitcher now for the Fillmore Eagles is up. Luke Colombo starting in left field. Now he's the pitcher. Takes one ball high and outside from Gabe to start with. 1-0. And a hard hit line drive over toward Tate Catney's in left. That's going to fall in there for a single for the pitcher. And a pretty nice piece of hitting right there.
That was a nice at bat for Colombo. Helps himself out a little bit by getting on base, and we'll see if Fillmore is able to knock him around. A nice job by Tate Catton. He's out there and left, Brian. You could see that Tate wanted to make an effort to maybe catch that ball in the air.
Yep.
Backed off, allowed it to hit this turf, and
made the sure play.
Made the sure play. That's right. When you're up 3-0, that's the right decision.
Big curveball in there, just a little bit low, 1-1 now for Graham Cahill, the right fielder today. Graham reached in the second inning via a walk. Called strike two on the outside corner. One ball, two strikes now.
That outside corner has been a good spot to be living, and he's been getting that call, as is Fillmore, has been getting that call all day long.
1-2 now. And a big swing and a miss. Strike three, going to retire Cahill, and that's going to be the second out of the inning. That's going to bring up the number eight hitter, Jude Beardsley.
Brian, for those that were able to watch and listen to us during the regular season, you know that we had a little bingo card, and folks from...
That one fouled off right off the top of the fence here behind the backstop. But quickly ahead, 0-1 now to the number eight hitter.
We had a bingo card, and those that were listening to us would tell us what state they were from. And I got a text message, we were able today to mark off Illinois off of our bingo card. We got about 10 to 12 folks sitting in Mundelein, Illinois, listening to CSP today. So we want to...
And a big swing and a miss. Strike three out for the number eight hitter. Roth just blew that one right by him for that third strike. He got one of them via breaking ball and two via fastballs that Beardsley could not catch up with. So two more strikeouts for Gabe in that fourth inning. And as we've seen throughout the year here, Gabe, as the game has gone on, has gotten more efficient and starting to get a little confidence now. So
yeah, after the first two innings, Brian, Gabe in the third faced minimum batters with five pitches. In the fourth, faced four batters with, I would say, probably less than 15 pitches or so. And so very efficient. So we'll take a break, and we'll be right back after these messages.
Spring broadcast comes from Lictus Oil and Propane in Clymer. Family-owned Lictus Oil and Propane continues to supply liquids and fluids for agriculture, industry, and homeowners. Heating oil and propane services and off-and-on diesel fuel services are also offered. The Channel 98.9 Sports Stream thanks Lictus Oil and Propane for their continued support.
This Wolfpack broadcast is brought to you in part by Arlene's Dutch Kitchen Restaurant and Becky's Bakery at 104 East Main Street in Sherman. Arlene's offers breakfast, lunch, and dinner. Becky's Bakery features Amish-style baked goods. 716-234-4002 or Arlene's Dutch Kitchen on Facebook.
If you could do something today that could save someone's life, would you do it? If it didn't cost you a dime and only took a little time and could literally save a life, would you do it? Can you believe that only 3% of people say yes to this? How's that possible? That's the real percentage of people who give blood. It's something you can do whether you're a millionaire, middle class, or completely poor. There's no fee and it's easy to do. And you can literally save a life. Let's roll up our sleeves and make a difference. Give blood. We can do better than 3%. Learn more at redcrossblood.org.
Funding for coverage of CSP baseball on the Channel 98.9 Lictus Oil and Propane Sports Stream is provided in part by First Place Auto Glass of Jamestown. Owner Glass Tech Robert Leonard from Panama installs automotive glass and works with all major insurance companies. We thank First Place Auto Glass, 716-450-0847 or on Facebook.
And welcome back to Salamanca as the CSP team getting ready to start the bottom half of the fourth inning. Going to bring Tate Catney's to the plate to lead off the Wolfpack inning here. Ball high and outside. 1-0 to Tate as the CSP team, as we've said, one run per inning so far. 3-0 CSP lead over Fillmore. And Tate Catney's with a deep fly ball to deep center field. Center fielder over there, that was hit really hard, just a little bit too much of the pop fly variety, but man, he got a lot of bat on that, Kyle.
Yes, he did, Brian. He hit that very well, and that was about the same spot on the field, Brian, that Trent hit his home run, and that was a long run for that center fielder.
Yes, it was.
And he kind of snow coned it a little bit, and but got the out, and but good hitting by Trent that or by Tate. That brings Grant Lictus to the plate, who struck out back in the second inning.
1-0 to Grant, takes the first one high and outside. And a big swing from the left-handed designated hitter for today, Grant Lictus. 1-1 now the count. Called strike on the inside corner.
And that's a tough spot for a lefty there.
Yep.
That's inside on his hand, in on his hands, Brian. It was a strike, but that's just a tough pitch to fight off, and so now he's got to protect here.
And Grant gets the bat on the ball, but fouls it over behind the CSP dugout. Kind of tight quarters here. There's a bank behind us. Sandals Market right behind us over here directly. And Tim Horton's in the vicinity as well here. So all sorts of commercial opportunities to hit windshields if that's your thing.
That has been the CSP thing pretty a lot this year, right from the very beginning.
2-2 now to Grant. And high and outside, good eye there by Grant. 3-2 now, full count. One down here, bottom of the fourth. Number 8 hitter up for CSP. 3-0 CSP lead over Fillmore. And Grant, another one fouled off behind the CSP dugout. So the count will remain full. That one did hit a car back over here in the auxiliary parking lot. I had a chance to park there, and I opted not to because I've been around this team. And high and outside, Grant's going to take his base. That was an excellent.
That was a great at bat.
Excellent
at bat. That was a great at bat for Grant. Gets his base on ball, but not after fighting off some really good pitches.
I think that was an 8-pitch at bat, which, man, that's just fantastic for the young hitter out of Clymer. That's going to bring Ian Dunnewald up. Called strike on the outside corner.
With the top of the lineup, Brian, up after Ian, and we've seen this a lot from Ian, I would not be surprised if if Coach Moreno wants to try to sacrifice him, Grant over to second, and we know Ian is very good at
he is excellent at
laying
that.
laying down bunts. But this might be a spot, particularly with the top of the order coming up.
And he does tries to have the swing and actually a the drag bunt is what he tried to do there almost, and tried to get a running start on that thing, but he fouled it off. 0-2 now, so that's going to take away the bunt as an opportunity. And ball outside. One ball, two strikes now to Ian.
Yeah, now what Ian wants to do is try to get base, bat on ball, in play, on the ground somewhere, if at the very least, and at least move that runner to second base.
And swinging third strike. And Grant's quickly over there trying to get back, and he does. He was kind of in no man's land a little bit. He wasn't really sure if that ball was fair or foul. I don't think actually Ian got any bat on the ball, and Grant was kind of stuck over there on first base. So Ian records the out, but Grant gets back just in time before the tag was applied. So that's going to be the second out of the inning, but the top of the order back up now. Here's Austin White makes his way to the plate. Grant Lictus at first. Two down now, bottom of the fourth. Timeout by Austin, granted by home plate umpire Bon Giovanni.
Austin 0-2 on the day. He
0-1.
0-1. Sorry,
walked in the third.
Walked back in the in the third.
Ball outside. 1-0 to Austin.
Looking for another little bit of two-out lightning for CSP here in the bottom of the fourth, up 3-0.
Ball low and outside. Austin did well to lay off that one. That looked pretty good from here, Kyle.
Yep.
Home plate umpire Bon Giovanni calls low. That one a little low.
Low and outside.
2-0 now for Austin White. Two down here, bottom of the fourth inning. Ball high, 3-0 now to Austin. Bringing the all-star catcher out of his crouch.
Really excited, Brian, about how number of people that are here today supporting CSP. It's
Austin was taken all the way on that one. That one right down Main Street. 3-1 now for Austin.
As we mentioned earlier, grandstand is completely full, and you've got a line of people down the third base line.
Foul back behind us here. That one hit something that was not of natural origins. I don't know what it was, but it was man-made. 3-2. Foul tip caught by the catcher, and that's going to be the third out, and that's going to be the end of the fourth inning for the Wolfpack, as that's the first inning today when we have not pushed any runs across the plate. But nonetheless, still lead 3-0 over Fillmore as we enter the top half of the fifth inning. We will be right back.
Funding for this Channel 98.9 Sports Stream broadcast comes from Lictus Oil and Propane in Clymer. Family-owned Lictus Oil and Propane continues to supply liquids and fluids for agriculture, industry, and homeowners. Heating oil and propane services and off-and-on diesel fuel services are also offered. The Channel 98.9 Sports Stream thanks Lictus Oil and Propane for their continued support.
Support for coverage of CSP Baseball on the Channel 98.9 Lictus Oil and Propane Sports Stream is provided by Triple E Manufacturing in Sherman. Triple E offers equine products, promotional items, embroidery, and printing services. 800-295-4282 or online at tripleemanufacturing.com.
Funding for this broadcast on the Channel 98.9 Lictus Oil and Propane Sports Stream is provided in part by J. Edwards Insurance. With offices at 9 East Main Street in Panama and 800 West 3rd Street in Jamestown, J. Edwards Insurance is an independent insurance service providing auto, business, farm, and homeowners insurance. We treat you like family. Online at jedwardsinsurance.com. Best of luck to the Wolfpack this season from J. Edwards Insurance, serving New York and Pennsylvania since 1957. This broadcast of CSP Wolfpack Baseball is provided by Land Pro Equipment at 1756 Lidquest Drive in Falconer and 8926 West Main Street in Clymer. Online at landproequip.com.
And welcome back here to the fifth inning of the Far West Regional as Gabe Ross going to toe the rubber again for the Wolfpack. He's going to bring up the number nine batter for the Fillmore Eagles, Damon Potter, starting pitcher for today, is now playing left field, and he takes the first one low and outside, ball one.
Potter struck out his first at bat, Brian, back in the second inning.
And a big, high, towering shot back toward Ian Dunwald in right field. It's got Ian backing all the way up. He got a lot of bat on that thing, and but Ian promptly gets underneath it and retires him. But that was a pretty well-hit ball to right field.
It was, Brian, and Ian had several steps backwards, and but nice at bat for Potter, and good job out there by Ian Dunwall getting underneath it and recording the first out.
And ball high and inside to the leadoff batter, Alex Ellsworth. Top of the order now.
Ellsworth 1-2, a hard single back in the first, struck out in the second. And
big swing and a miss right there on the outside corner. Good spot for that pitch by Gabe.
And, yeah, that was a really good spot. But you can kind of see, Brian, Gabe settling in really nicely here after the first two innings.
Same spot. Couldn't get him to chase that one. Two balls and a strike now to Alex Ellsworth.
In fact, since that second inning, Brian, one hit for Fillmore over the last two and the third inning.
Ball up a little high. Three balls and a strike now. One down here, top of the fifth inning. 3-0 CSP over Fillmore. Called strike on the outside corner as the runner started to take his base down first. Chad says not so fast. Back in the batter's box you go. Full count now.
Yeah, and umpires typically do not.
They don't like that much.
Like that very much, Brian.
And a hard chopper toward Gabe. Hard charging. Going to be a play over there for Austin, and he can't make the play. The shortstop playing the deep part of that, and that was just a slow roller. And just kind of hit no man's land there between over the top of Gabe on the high bouncer and in front of Austin, and he's going to have an infield single.
Yeah, that ball bounced really high and took a lot of time to come back down, Brian, and then with our guy, with our shortstop playing so deep, but just a long run for Austin. And really had no shot at getting the speedy Ellsworth at first base.
Oh, the lefty Sisson up to the plate. Once again, a throw over to first base. They almost got him leaning again over there. There's been a couple close plays on Ellsworth over there at first base. But he's back safely. 0-1 now to the big lefty from Fillmore. Once again, over to first. And Bryce applies the tag, but nothing doing.
It'll be interesting to see how aggressive the down 3-0, how aggressive the Fillmore coaching staff wants to be on the bases.
Called strike two with a good pitch up to the plate with Gabe right there. Now ahead of the batter, 0-2.
Zach Sisson, along with his battery partner Ellsworth, with a hard single back in the first and strikeout in the third. Gabe really paying attention to the base runner at first. That typically, Brian, will turn into bad things.
And he throws that one to home, and Sisson fouls that one off behind the CSP dugout down the left field line. 0-2 now to Sisson.
See if he can get Sisson, Brian, to chase something out of the strike zone here.
Micah sets up on the outside corner. And that's a little low. That was a really good pitch by Gabe.
Yeah, you put it right where Micah wanted it, Brian, and that's a perfect spot on 0-2 because just almost.
1-2, once again, throw over to first, paying a lot of attention to the speedy Ellsworth over there. Curveball misses on the outside, 2-2 to Sisson. So now let's settle back in, Gabe. Let's get the batter here. And a high pop fly. Shallow center field. Copta makes the play, makes it a little more adventurous than maybe it needed to be, but nonetheless, it ends up in his glove, and he's in from his center field position. He did have quite a long run on
He had a long run in, Brian. That was a high fly ball, but he long run in and kind of caught it off to the side a little bit, but at the end of the day, it's an out. And it's two outs here now in the top of the fifth, and Gabe again checking over to first base.
Bryce is going to have that arm all nice and warmed up in case we need him a little bit later today for a reason.
And
that one actually gets away from him, which eventually in high school baseball.
That eventually is going to happen,
that
Brian.
That is going to happen.
It just is eventually going to happen.
Yep, and whether you're one of every four or one of every six, or in this case about one of every eight, makes its way to the fence. So Ellsworth gets his base over to second base. That leaves Krasminski at the plate here. Ball low. So now Gabe can concentrate on the batter. Two down here. Man on second base. Krasminski, the number three batter, up at the plate. Gabe behind 1-0 to the number three batter.
That puts Ellsworth in scoring position, Brian. He's fast, so any base hit out of the infield.
And there's a line drive shot right at Tate Catney. He didn't even have to move. And that was a well-hit ball, but Tate had that defended very well. And the freshman out of Panama just puts his glove up and flies right into it. Fairly routine play for him, but that's going to retire the Fillmore fifth inning. They did get the bat on the ball a little bit, but not enough to push any runs across. And they leave the one runner on second base. So that's going to leave the score 3-0 CSP as we get ready to enter the bottom half of the fifth. We'll be right back.
Funding for this Channel 98.9 Sports Stream broadcast comes from Lictus Oil and Propane in Clymer. Family-owned Lictus Oil and Propane continues to supply liquids and fluids for agriculture, industry, and homeowners. Heating oil and propane services and off-and-on diesel fuel services are also offered. The Channel 98.9 Sports Stream thanks Lictus Oil and Propane for their continued support.
Support for coverage of CSP Baseball on the Channel 98.9 Lictus Oil and Propane Sports Stream is provided by Triple E Manufacturing in Sherman. Triple E offers equine products, promotional items, embroidery, and printing services. 800-295-4282 or online at tripleemanufacturing.com.
Funding for this broadcast on the Channel 98.9 Lictus Oil and Propane Sports Stream is provided in part by J. Edwards Insurance. With offices at 9 East Main Street in Panama and 800 West 3rd Street in Jamestown, J. Edwards Insurance is an independent insurance service providing auto, business, farm, and homeowners insurance. We treat you like family. Online at jedwardsinsurance.com. Best of luck to the Wolfpack this season from J. Edwards Insurance, serving New York and Pennsylvania since 1957. This broadcast of CSP Wolfpack Baseball is provided by Land Pro Equipment at 1756 Lidquest Drive in Falconer and 8926 West Main Street in Clymer. Online at landproequip.com.
And welcome back to Salamanca as the CSP Wolfpack are going to get ready to prepare for the bottom half of the fifth. They're going to take that with a 3-0 lead over the Fillmore Eagles out of Section 5. Pretty well-played game so far, Kyle. There's been a lot of hitting, a lot of people getting some bat on the ball. You know, there's been not that big inning. It's been a pretty much a defensive battle for both teams. 3-0 is your score, and it's been a pretty good contest.
Yeah, the difference to this point, Brian, is CSP's gotten hits when they had base runners, and Fillmore just missed opportunities there back in the first and second inning runners on second, third, and were unable with one out and were unable to get them in. And so positive for CSP, but if you're Fillmore, you're going to look back and say those are opportunities maybe lost.
And a hard hit ball between the first and second baseman for Bryce Hinsdale is going to have himself a leadoff single here for the Wolfpack in the top or the bottom half of the fifth inning, and a very well hit ball by the freshman out of Panama there.
Yeah, that's
turned
better
on that one.
That's better there by Bryce. A little bit more aggressive at the plate, not as tentative, and was able to get a nice base hit. Now that's a leadoff runner for CSP here in the top of the fifth, bottom of the fifth, up 3-0.
Gabe Roth takes one low and outside.
We mentioned earlier, Brian, that we've got our bingo card, and we were able to check off Illinois, check off Virginia off of that bingo card. As we've got a group of group of folks down in Trotville, Virginia, listening to CSP Radio.
As Gabe hits one, a deep fly ball to center field, but the center fielder had a lot of time to get underneath. Gabe got a lot of air on that one, and that's going to be a fly out to center field, and that's going to be the first out of the inning. So once again, thanks to everybody listening out there in Cyberland, and this is a great thing. So we're glad to be able to bring the game to you here. Thank you to all the sponsors of CSP Wolfpack Baseball. And Micah hits one down the first baseline. That's going to be a potential double play, but the ball actually on the transfer from the second baseman to the first baseman, and they're going to have Micah out by quite a long ways at second base as he tried to get it there on the pass ball, and that's the second time today Micah's been caught stealing because of the small real estate here in Fillmore. And that's actually a double play, kind of an unconventional double play, but that's going to end the inning for the Wolfpack.
Yeah, that was what started off to be a relatively promising inning, Brian.
Quickly ended.
And so we had a fly out. Bryce led off the inning with a nice base hit to get on, and Gabe with a pop fly, and then Micah with a what ultimately ended up being a double play, but that was a ball that Micah hit to first base. The first baseman threw it to the shortstop, who was covering second, so that got Bryce out, and a little bit of a errant throw from the shortstop to first base, which resulted in Micah out beating the throw, but the ball got to the backstop over on the first base line. Micah thought he could make it.
You got 90 feet between the bases and only about 25 feet over to the ball. That's the problem.
Well, and the other problem too, Brian, is that Micah was trying to beat out that run. So he had run quite a ways past first base.
Yeah.
So he was really deep into, to some degree, deep into right field before he when he decided to take off for second. So he probably ran quite a bit further than the 90 feet for sure.
Yeah.
Either way, he was out by a
pretty good amount. I think the only question there was whether when he slid into the base, if the ball dropped out of the second baseman's mitt. But he held on to it, and that was a fairly easy call for the umpiring crew. So anyway, kind of snake bitting a little bit here with the little less real estate here than what we've been traditionally used to has resulted in two outs for Micah anyway.
But story of the day, Brian, is that you got a CSP team that's six outs away from going to Binghamton next Friday and Saturday to play for a state title. So top of the six here for Fillmore, CSP up 3-0. And again, six outs is the key right here.
Number four batter coming up for Fillmore here. Takes the first one low. Makes its way to the backstop, actually. And that one's fouled out behind us here. 1-1 now to Zubikowski, who was a part of that kind of crazy double play in that inning.
Zubikowski 0-2, Brian, with a strikeout and a flyout back, fly out to Bryce back in
the. And that
the,
one's a deep fly ball to center. Blake coped underneath it and promptly records the out. That was kind of a little bit of a gapper, but luckily he got just enough air under that. It gave Blake an opportunity to get out underneath it, but that's going to be a pretty well-hit ball. But Blake coped plays in center field position very well out there. There's a reason that he likes that, or the coaching staff likes him out there.
Yeah, good job by Blake. Made that one look more conventional than the last one he caught. But either way, two outputs for Blake. One down here in the top of the sixth.
One ball, one strike to Aiden Wagner. That one a little bit low and outside. 1-1 now. Top of the sixth inning. And that one hit. Pretty good piece of hitting, but that one's going to make its way out of play down the right field line. One ball and two strikes to Aiden Wagner as everybody's going to have to jog back to their positions. Got a lot of bat on that thing, but ends up over basically in the bullpen on the out of play area here. Got a pesky fly I'm going to try and get rid of here in a minute.
I wish we had video for this, Brian.
If I start swinging at pink elephants, it's time to get me out of here. And that one's a hard hit ball to Trent Burchanowski down the right-hand side. Trent bobbles it, But they get the play over at first on the double clutch from Trent, and Bryce gets his big mitt on that and retires the second batter of the inning, Aiden Wagner.
Yeah, luckily Trent's playing second there, because that ball, he didn't have far to throw it, because he bobbled it a little bit and then made a very quick throw over to Bryce, and Bryce was able to stretch out and record second out.
And a swing and a miss for the starting left fielder, Luke Colombo. Two down here, top of the sixth inning, 0-1 to Colombo. Big curveball. Tried to hit that one again. That one misses a little high, 1-1.
And as you're trying to look ahead and strategize a little bit, Brian, this is a big out here if you're able to get it for CSP, because that would mean batters 7, 8, and 9 in the top of the seventh for that Gabe would face. So just as you're thinking about the lineup and where they're at in the hitting order, this turns out to be a pretty big at bat here.
And he's quickly behind on that count, 3-1 now. So, Gabe, you need to talk a little louder, Kyle. 3-1 now, two outs to the number six batter. And he hits one hard. That's going to be into the gap between Curtis Olsen and a diving Austin White. Makes his way out to left field. So, Colombo, second hit of the day for him. And he found his way down to first base, which is going to bring up Graham Cahill.
Good job by Colombo there, getting, again, his second hit of the day. And facing now Gabe will face Graham Cahill, who is 0-for-1 on the day, walked back in the second inning and struck out in the fourth.
That one outside, 2-0 now. As Gabe labors a little bit with the bottom part of the order here. 2-0 to Cahill. That one inside, 3-0 now. As that's going to bring Jake Marino out of the CSP dugout, find out what's going on. First two batters retired pretty quickly. Five-pitch walk to Colombo, or a five-pitch with a single hard hit to Colombo, and a three-pitch count to three balls and no strikes to Cahill. And we'll see what's going on with the big righty from CSP here.
Yeah, and Brian, if I'm Coach Marino, I'm the conversation I'm having with Gabe is, you know, just throw strikes, just make these guys hitters, and you know, this is the last thing you want to do is put runners in scoring position for Fillmore on your own. So make them just Micah set up right behind the plate, fastball right down the middle. That's what that was right there. That's 3-1. I would go right back
to there again.
Two more of those if I'm Gabe and Micah.
Here comes a 3-1. And a hard hit ball. And that one's going to be off of Trent's foot over into left field. And that's going to actually require Tate Catanese from his left field position to get there. Second base, and Trent's rolling around out there as he gets ran into from the base runner. Ball on the ground a lot here in that inning for the CSP Wolfpack. Off Trent's foot twice, I think, throughout the course of that inning. Once in the left field, and then again on the play towards second. But that's going to be runners now on second and third as Cahill makes his way over there on a hard hit ball.
Yeah, Brian, that is all of that right there is very uncharacteristic of CSP. That is not something that we've typically done, and that is kind of throw the ball, make errors, throw the ball around the field. So that brings up number eight hitter Jude Beardsley for Fillmore.
Called strike. Beardsley had a sacrifice bunt in the first inning and struck out swinging in the fourth. And a hard hit ball right back to Gabe at his pitching position, and that's going to once again allow the Wolfpack to get out of the inning. Man, that Fillmore team is just a little bit snake-bitten here. They've had runners second and third with two outs. Now that's the third inning out of five today and haven't been able to get a run across. So job well done by the Wolfpack with the bend but don't break mentality there.
Yeah, Brian, that's six innings. Three of those six, as you mentioned, Fillmore's had runners on second, third, with two of those times being with one out, and just have not been able to get timely hitting that they needed to get a run across the plate. And it's fortunate for CSP, and I think, I think by all accounts, Gabe would say that he's been off a little bit today. But CSP still with a 3-0 lead here as we enter the bottom half of the sixth. That means as we come to the plate, we're going to see 5, 6, and 7 for CSP, and on the bottom of the or on the top of the seventh, when CSP goes back out looking for three outs to go to the state finals, we're going to see the 9-1-2 hitters for Fillmore.
So as we we'll stay with you here as we go to the bottom half of the sixth inning, the Wolfpack team, as you would expect, as you go along in the playoffs here, each one of these games gets a little tougher. And other than that Maple Grove game, this has been the closest variety of a game for us this year, which is good. Puts us in a position where we haven't been an awful lot. But, as you start to get toward the end of these innings, that's when some of these mental errors potentially start to kind of pop up a little bit. And, guys get a little tight, start thinking ahead just a little bit. But so far, the Wolfpack have been able to, like I mentioned, bend but not break. And so far, 3-0 CSP lead as we get ready to start the sixth inning for the Wolfpack.
Yeah, and the Wolfpack, Brian, here in the bottom of the sixth, looking to add some insurance runs to eliminate some of that pressure that they might feel in the top of the seventh, up 3-0, with the kind of the heart of our order coming up. Just a quick update. Brian is still attempting to kill this fly.
I'm going to give myself rotator cuff issues here, swinging at this fly.
Broke his finger up against
against the windowsill. That hurt.
And this could result in an ER visit for sure.
Trent Berchanowski didn't look to be any worse for the wear, despite hitting two balls off his ankle in that top half of the inning. Follows one back. 0-1 now to Trent to lead off the CSP Wolfpack sixth inning. And another hard chopper. Foul ball down the left field side. 0-2 now to Trent.
Now Trent's got to protect a little bit, maybe shorten that swing up and try to at least get bat on the ball here and get a leadoff runner for CSP.
Trent with a big home run in the second and a single in the third, so swinging a very hot bat today. Another foul. I think he'd like that one back.
He would like that one back, and I'm shocked, Brian. If I'm Fillmore's coaches, I might pay a visit and say, listen, you're up 0-2. This ball should be nowhere near the strike zone.
That one was right down the middle.
Right down the middle.
Might have been a little bit of a mistake by the junior pitcher. Trent hammers another one toward left field. It's got everybody moving. Just about out to the warning track. That was in the same general vicinity as the one he hit the home run on. Trent with a lot of bat on that one. That was about as deep as you could hit it and not actually hit it against the fence. Trent Berchanowski with a deep fly ball, but it's going to result in an out. But, man, held your breath for a second on that one.
Yeah, he hit that ball hard, Brian. And again, I just don't know if you're Fillmore. That ball was right down the middle of the plate again. So that brings Curtis Olson, one of two seniors on the at least in the starting lineup for CSP, along with Micah Willink. So as you're thinking,
and Ian,
Ian, yes, yep. That's right, three,
and a big swing and a miss for Curtis there. That was a good ball to be swinging on. He just couldn't quite catch up with it, high and inside. Curtis with a big swing, 1-1 now for Olson.
Ian, the valedictorian for Clymer. Curtis, the salutatorian for Panama.
A lot of brain power. We like that.
Yeah.
2-1 now. Curtis fouls one down the third baseline. Excuse me, 1-2. 1-2. One down here. Top of the sixth inning. And a swing and a miss for Curtis. That's going to be the second out of the inning. Tate Catanese with two down here, bottom of the sixth. We'll see if the number nine, Tate Catanese, playing left field. He's had some action out there today. That one way outside. Tate quickly ahead, 1-0.
Tate with a sacrifice back in the second inning and a really deep fly ball, fly out in the fourth.
Called strike. One ball, one strike to Tate. Tate on the kind of the one that got away from the pitcher, right on the inside, high and tight, and Tate kind of trying to get out of the way, decided to take a swat at it. 1-2 now. Tate gets a bat on the ball, slow roller down to third base. With Tate's speed, that's going to be close, but they're going to get the out as the big arm from the third baseman over there is going to record the out. So that's going to be a 5-3 put out, and that's going to be a quick 1-2-3 inning for the Wolfpack. And the score is going to remain CSP 3, Fillmore 0, as we enter the top half of the seventh inning. We will be right back.
Funding for this broadcast on the Channel 98.9 Lictus Oil and Propane Sports Stream is provided in part by J. Edwards Insurance. With offices at 9 East Main Street in Panama and 800 West 3rd Street in Jamestown, J. Edwards Insurance is an independent insurance service providing auto, business, farm, and homeowners insurance. We treat you like family. Online at jedwardsinsurance.com. Best of luck to the Wolfpack this season from J. Edwards Insurance, serving New York and Pennsylvania since 1957. This broadcast of CSP Wolfpack Baseball is brought to you by Pudge's Tire at 5979 Niobe Road in Panama, serving all your tire needs. Phone 716-782-4009.
Coverage of CSP Wolfpack Baseball is provided in part by White Land Surveying and Clymer, providing land surveys for clients in Chautauqua and Cattaraugus counties in New York and Erie, Warren, and Crawford counties in Pennsylvania. Call 716-499-8410 or visit online at mwhitepls.com.
Funding for this Channel 98.9 Sports Stream broadcast comes from Lictus Oil and Propane in Clymer. Family-owned Lictus Oil and Propane continues to supply liquids and fluids for agriculture, industry, and homeowners. Heating oil and propane services and off-and-on diesel fuel services are also offered. The Channel 98.9 Sports Stream thanks Lictus Oil and Propane for their continued support.
All right, as we enter the top half of the seventh inning, it's going to bring the Fillmore team up. Called strike one for Gabe Roth on the outside corner.
Three outs needed here for CSP to book their trip to Binghamton next Friday and Saturday in the state finals. So, as we were talking during the break, Brian, this is a time when things might get a little tight for CSP as you're thinking a little bit ahead. So you want to make sure that take care of business here with a 3-0 lead in the on the top of the seventh, 3-1 count here, I believe, to Potter.
Called strike on the outside corner. Good pitch there by Gabe. Full count. And a high chopper. Going to be a hard charging. Austin White on the relay. He's going to be safe as a sliding runner makes the great effort running down the line and just beat the throw from Austin. That ball, just because of the turf, was a really high chopper, and Austin did the best he could to get to it, but not before Potter slides in safe at first base. He's got himself an infield single, leadoff single, and Fillmore's in business. And there's a deep fly ball to center field. Blake Copta out there. It's kind of a lazy pop fly. Blake retires the batter. So a lot of action here as we start the seventh inning, but that's going to be a fly out in the first out of the inning.
Yeah, going back to the ball that Potter hit, Brian, again, that's the second time we've seen it where the ball hits really hard right in front of the plate, a big bouncing ball over Gabe, and because of Austin, how deep he's playing, makes it difficult, but able to get the leadoff hitter for Fillmore to Ellsworth to fly out to center. So one out here, and that's a pop up
right to Trent Berchanowski at second base. Actually, Bryce Hinsdale calls him off smartly, and that's going to be the second out of the inning as the two underclassmen do a great job communicating with each other over there from their first and second bases respectively. And Bryce calls him off with the sunglasses. That was a great play by Bryce.
So two outs here for CSP in the top of the seventh, up 3-0, and that brings Nolan Kraminski to the plate.
Ball high. 1-0.
If you're an outfielder for CSP, you want to keep everything in front of you. You want to knock everything down. If you're an infielder, just try to eliminate any sort of big inning here.
And 2-0 as that one just misses on the outside corner. Two down here, top of the seventh inning. 3-0 CSP over Fillmore. Fillmore down to their last out here, Kyle. And a hard hit up the middle. Diving Trent Berchanowski can't get there, but that's only going to advance that first base runner over to second base as Blake hoped to quickly over, but now they have two runners in scoring position, first and second.
All right, if you're Fillmore, you got something cooking here. You've got runners at first and second with two outs. That's going to be their problem with two outs here. And you've got
cleanup hitter Brent Zubikowski, so you got to think he's got some power. Zubikowski, the junior out of Fillmore, big, talk about a big spot.
And if you're Gabe here, the one thing that can beat you on one swing is a home run. You want to keep the ball low. You want to keep the ball low, force a ground ball or a lazy pop fly. Anything high, he can try to chase and put over the fence.
Quickly head 0-2, two called strikes on the outside corner back-to-back from the same exact spot. So Gabe quickly head 0-2 to the number four batter, Zubikowski. And a foul. Did well to get the bite on the ball on that one. 0-2 as the count. Two down here. Runners on first and second, top of the seventh.
And if I'm Gabe and Micah, this ball has nowhere near the strike zone.
And it wasn't. In fact, it makes its way to the plate, to the fence. And that allows the runners to advance.
I'm not sure I meant to be that far out of the
strike
zone.
No, that one was outside the strike zone for sure. That one caught Micah by surprise. And unfortunately, that one did not bounce back the way the others have. So that allows the runners to advance. So now second and third with two down. And he gets the bat on the ball. Curtis Olsen charging. And he throws it over to right field. And actually, that's going to score the second run for Fillmore as Curtis Olsen with a wide throw. And that scores both runners from second and third. So that makes the score 3-2 as Zubikowski reaches on the hard hit ball. Actually, wasn't hard hit. It was kind of a slow roller that Curtis Olsen couldn't gather.
Yeah, you almost look at that, Brian, and you wonder if you're Curtis. Maybe the play was there to hold on to it and just live to see another day. And Coach Moreno, I think wisely, went out and had a little conference at the mound and said, "Hey, fellas, let's take a deep breath and relax here. We got one out. We got to get to win this ball game. That's going to bring Aiden Wagner to the plate here.
Ball on the outside, 1-0 to Wagner.
Number 19, Aiden Wagner. The fat lady is not sung yet, fans. 1-0 count here. Ross, next pitch on the way.
And a deep fly ball to right center field. Ian Dunewald parked underneath it. Makes the play out there. What a ball game. Ian Dunewald with the game-saving third out pop fly from the number five hitter for Fillmore. And the CSP team is congregated on the dugout on the pitching mound and is jumping all around. What a great ball game for both teams. CSP is going to come away from this with a 3-2 hard-earned victory over a gritty Fillmore squad.
Yeah, Brian, that is a game that we have not been in all year long. And it got a little tense at the end, and you could see some players starting to get a little tight. But
I might have too.
Yeah, no kidding. No kidding. And but 3-2 CSP victory here. And, Brian, that gets us a date in the state finals. I believe semifinal game is on Friday.
Well,
Friday or Saturday.
There's some question on that, whether it's going to be Friday or Saturday. But either way, we'll figure that out later.
But we will be in Binghamton next weekend for sure. And we will be bringing the game to you right here on Channel 98.9. a really nice job by the Fillmore Eagles. I know, Brian, that they were down one of their better players. Mitchell Ward got hurt early in the year. I read a little bit about him. He may have actually been one of Fillmore's better players, and he had an arm injury that put him out for the year. But a really nice, gritty effort by the Fillmore Eagles to even get to this point. But CSP prevails 3-2 in what became a very close game. And we live to see another day. So it'll be exciting. The next week will be really exciting for CSP.
Yeah, just a great ball game. Neither team had that really breakout inning, and no more than five batters approached the plate for any team in either inning. So we mentioned it in the pregame, the defensive struggle or the defensive prowess of Fillmore just as good as the defensive prowess for the CSP team, and just a really well played ball game all the way around. And it's a really gritty and a very, very well-played 3-2 game for the Wolfpack. Going to get themselves a Far West Regional crown. And to my knowledge, going to advance to the semifinal round. And I don't know if a Clymer team has made it that far before. I know a Panama team has not. And so the CSP team for sure is this is the first time that they've advanced to a state semifinal game in the baseball diamond. So just great stuff happening, and this has just been a heck of a run, and we're looking for good things for next weekend in Binghamton.
Yeah, and a great crowd. We've mentioned it a couple times today, Brian, a great crowd for CSP today. Grandstands full, and a lot of support for this baseball team. And again, shows the power of bringing CSP together and the things that they can do. And it's very good stuff. We're seeing it on the football field. We're seeing it on the track field. Both yesterday and today is a number of CSP athletes take to the track field to try to go to states and put baseball on the list because we're heading to Binghamton.
Yeah, and we can add one more name to the list of states here as Trevor and Dick Watrous are playing in a golf outing out in Colorado. I thought I heard a little scream when that third out was recorded, and that was probably those guys. So shout out to them. Support coming in from all corners. Teams are going to send representatives out to the home plate area with the Section 6 representative going to present the Fillmore team with their award for runners-up in the Far West region, and just really a really nice season for them. I think they end their season 19-4, so obviously they've had a very successful season, and just the way this thing works, only one team can advance. But really good job there by Fillmore. Congratulations on a great season to them and their staff. And they're young. They're going to be around.
Yeah, they are young.
They got three seniors on that team. So similar to CSP, going to be around for a while, hopefully.
Six and now Far West Regional Champions from CSP, the Wolfpack.
CSP Wolfpack with the congratulations from the Section 6 representatives at home plate as the captains make their way out there and are presented the plaque for the Far West Region. So congratulations, Coach Marino, the coaching staff, the players, the administrations. Micah hoists the trophy in the air, and that's going to be a pretty good picture for some parents.
Yes, it is, Brian. This is cool stuff, and as we've talked before, this team, as they set out goals at the beginning of the year, they've been checking them off the list, and to get to the states, you got to win at Far West Regionals, and they were able to do that. And we are, as far as I know, Brian, with unfortunately the Westfield softball team losing last night and the Faulkner girls softball losing last night, we may be the one Southern Tier team remaining, and so that's kind of exciting. But again, we're checking things off. We're checking things off the list, and there's two more check marks we need to make, and that is win a state semifinal, and then bring the state title home.
Well, as we get ready to take it away from Salamanca, this has just been a great day for baseball. Two great teams, great facility, great ball game, and the CSP Wolfpack is the queen. We are the champions plays in the background here. That's going to do it from Salamanca. On behalf of Kai Hinsdale, I'm Brian Willink. Thanks for listening, and we will see you next Friday from Binghamton. Thanks for listening.
Thanks for listening to this broadcast of CSP Wolfpack Baseball on the Channel 989 Lictus Oil and Propane Sports Stream at channel989.org. This broadcast is presented by J. Edwards Insurance in Panama and Jamestown, First Place Auto Glass of Jamestown, Sherman Livestock, by Arlene's Dutch Kitchen Restaurant and Becky's Bakery in Sherman, Triple E Manufacturing, TripleEMFG.com, Countertop Solutions, by Mosher's Carpeting of Clymer, by Land Pro Equipment in Falconer and Clymer, also Pudge's Tire in Panama, Sherman County General Store, White Land Surveying in Clymer, and by Lictus Oil and Propane in Clymer, LictusOilandPropane.com. Tune in next time for all the action of CSP Wolfpack Baseball.